Yes, marvel at the starry sky. It looks so majestic, doesn't it? Yep. Anyway, what's happening, everybody? This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back again with more Super Luigi Galaxy. When we last left off, we, got the third and final green power star, but we still did not finish Dusty Dune Galaxy. As close as we were. But we are going to be finishing it now. We're going to get the last hidden star in this place and finally move on from this galaxy. Okay, back to Sunbaked Sandcastle. We're going after the regular hidden star this time. And, yes. Pretty much we're just doing the same thing that we've been doing. So yeah, we're just going to be doing lots of waiting. I guess I could edit through this, but... yeah, I mean, this is only the second time we've been to this mission, so I guess I won't edit through it, but yeah. Still just trying not to get crushed here. Life Mushroom, thank you very, very much. And there we go. Yeah, we don't have to go very far. So yeah, Star Chips once again. Let's pull that up. Ground Pound that. And let's see, we got the, oh yeah, we got this one right here. We got the treasure chest one. Oh yeah, I guess I should go ahead and get these star bits, shouldn't I? Alright, so we'll just drop off right here, catch the ledge, there we go. No, 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 do not fall off, thank you very much. And yeah, we got dry bones up this. What the? Okay, they just like totally blocked me from doing a side flip up there. Yeah, thanks a lot. And yeah, we just wall jump and grab the last star chip. Wee wee wee. And there's our star. Yeah, don't really have a whole lot to say right now. But now that we've arrived on this planet. Now we're gonna have to do a little bit of work. So, you may have just seen right here that there was a stump that was just barely buried in the sand. And let's get rid of this crab. Come here, buddy. Yeah, the red crabs creep up on you, the blue ones run away from you, but the blue ones give you one up, so. Yeah, this planet right here. As you can, you may be able to tell, but yes, the amount of sand on this planet, gradually increases and decreases its diameter. So what we need to do is we need to find that stump. That stump that just appeared. I have no idea where it is. There we go. And music notes appear. All right. So we just collect these. Come on. There we go. Just a few more. All right. And that makes another launch star appear. And we jump up into this one. And this will take us to this planet over here with this bullet bill cannon. And yeah, we're pretty much right next to where we just were about a minute ago. Now what we need to do is ground pound this button right here. Or platform, whatever it is. And yeah, the bullet bills are just gonna keep being fired out. Now what this is gonna do is that this actually, ground pounding that thing will not only raise up the tower, but it'll also raise up the cage with the star in it. And the quickest way to do this is to stand right here, and when the next bullet bill fires, you just jump in front of him and get his attention. You could use that rainbow star to kill all the dry bones, I mean, and it will give you extra star bits, but I'm not really gonna worry too much about it. So let's just grab this guy, lure him over here. Hello! And there's our star, alright. So, let's see. Let's jump. And that did not work. Okay, so I'm thinking what I need to do... I could just, well... yeah, I guess it would be easier to just ground pound the thing back. But I don't want to have to do all that. There we go. There we go. Made it to the top. Then there's our hidden star. Woo! That's probably the shortest mission in this entire galaxy right there. I don't know. Still took about 5 minutes, but anyway. Bullet Bill on Your Back. I love that title. Anyway. And to my knowledge, now that we have completed that, with 6 stars, Dusty Dune Galaxy is finished as much as it can be. So, finally, it is now time to talk to the Hungry Luma. Here we go. He needs 800 star bits. Alright, wow. He's a hungry feller. Let's feed him good. That's definitely a hell of a lot better than the 20 star bits we used to feed him, to feed the Hungry Luma in Dusty Dune Galaxy. But anyway, there we go. And what do we have? The Bigmouth Galaxy has appeared. Okay. I really, really, really like this galaxy right here. This is probably one of my, my favorite Hungry Luma galaxy from the observatory. Bigmouth's gold bait. Alright. We're gonna go into the fish's mouth. Alright, yeah, the fish's mouth. It's the only planet in this entire galaxy. With very sinister, haunting music. And piano notes, though. But anyway, yeah. This galaxy is, like, I think that's the reason why I like it so much, is because it has, like, a really dark tone to it. Oh, come on. Hit him on the weak spot. There we go. Okay, yeah, star bits. You can break what would presumably be, like, the giant stone fish's teeth. Oh, fine. You can run away for right now, crab, but I will catch up to you. Just like that. Give me that one up. Okay, so what do we got here? This chest will only open for the shell that shines. Alright, so yes. If we try to throw this green Koopa shell at this chest, it ain't gonna open. Oh, that's not good. And yes, we can also get burned. So, yes, we have Panguru right here, stroking his beard. Let's talk to him. His ever-so-luscious beard. This is my hideaway. It's the perfect spot for fishing, being left alone. Alright, so, yes, clearly we know what kind of person Panguru is. Let's grab this Koopa shell. That way, swimming in the water will be a little bit easier. So we jump down here, and we've got a couple boos down here. You can, like, shine the light on the boos to kill them. And there is a one-up down there. I'm just going to go ahead and skip on past it, though. So, yes, we'll just break through the brick blocks. Now, this part here, you have to collect 5 star chips to make a sling star. And in turn, that sling star is going to shoot you up to... we can't zoom in. But, yeah, you can see that there's water up above us. Taking that sling star from the star chips will, you know, shoot us up into that upper portion. But you don't need to collect those star chips because you can kind of glitch out this level. Actually, it's not even really a glitch. You can just do that. You can just wall jump up the side right there. And yeah, you don't even need a Koopa shell to jump up here. And with that, you can collect the golden shell that shines. All right. Like, once you know your way around this mission, it's a very easy level. And again, and that, like, that's not really why it's my favorite level. I just like it for its design, but still. It's, like, very simple to get through. And, yeah, there's a whole lot of boos this time. All give us coins here. But, yes. Jump up out of the water. And with the gold shell, you can break open the chest. And it's Captain Toad! Man, that was close. Oh, Luigi, I almost forgot to tell you something. I was trying to get a star, but I fell in this treasure chest. It's smaller than it looks. Oh, you look like you could fit in there. Maybe except for your head, but still. It doesn't look that bad. Like, you gotta think about it, like, how tall are toads in general? Like, yes, I know to take the power star, but yeah, how tall in general are toads? Like, they can't be that tall. Cause, like, no, I don't know. I'm thinking about it too hard. Alright, and with Bigmouth Galaxy complete, we will head back into the bedroom dome, which, yeah, we're already there. And it is now time to open up the boss galaxy. What are we gonna have here? Bowser's Dark Matter Plant. Alright, it's gonna be a rematch with Bowser. So let's go and fire into the side of his face. And we shall have darkness on the horizon. Sounds so awesomely menacing, doesn't it? Like, it's crazy. I love it. so sinister. And yes, obviously we're going to be dealing with a lot of gravity scrambles here. Yeah, this isn't too hard of a level, although I shouldn't really say that because I'm probably just going to jinx myself. But yeah, this isn't too hard of a level. I mean, obviously it's a step up in difficulty since the last Bowser fight. And that was like all the way back at the fountain, but still. Yeah, there's dark matter everywhere. As long as you don't fall into the dark matter, you will be good. And with these arrows here, that signifies which way the gravity is pointing. So just, you know, adjust your position accordingly. Yeah. I sound so, like, unnecessarily professional there. It's like, adjust your position accordingly. Like a friggin' GPS system or whatever. Anyway, yes, jump up here. We got a row of coins. And even more coins in this box right here. I kind of like how, like, the level goes to, like, 2.5D right here. Kind of like a neat little throwback to, like, the original Mario Brothers games. And last Goomba, give me your star bits. Alright, we just annihilated those guys. And yes, now that the dark matter is like eating holes in the platforms or whatever, as this Luma will tell us right here. Yes, eating holes in space. Because dark matter is hungry for holes in space. So yes, we're just waiting. I don't think... Uh-oh. Oh, easy there, Luigi. Easy there, Trigger. Oh yeah, and by the way, you can't actually get crushed by those platforms when they come together, so... Yeah. Be very, very careful. Very, very bad man. Okay. I will say the dark matter looks really cool. Anyway, there's a 1-up right there. Wow, 30 lives. Then again, I did get the... Whoa, what the heck just happened there? Okay. I was about to say, I got the 20 lives from Mail Toad at the beginning, but still, I don't know what was up with that gravity thing. Yahoo! Okay, yeah, I'm not gonna jump that way, because I do not want to die. This level is too easy to keep dying in. Right. Switch, and we just jump. And jump right here. Alright, and yeah. Waiting for the gravity to change. Yes, more waiting. But at least this isn't, like... I mean, yeah, you're doing a little bit of waiting, but it's not tedious. Not in the least. And then it's gonna, like, flip up the gravity. Okay, jump up here. And one more gravity switch, swap, change, whatever the frig it is. And we jump over here. Right. Goom Beetle, we'll just ignore him. Wow. He perfectly placed me on the platform. Thank you there, sir. Alright. Free the Luma and... Yes, thank you for telling me to use the stairs here. I would have never guessed that you had to use the stairs to actually get up to the next part. Like, wow. It's just incredible. Like, yeah, thank you for the hints there, sir. The obvious hints... Obvious hints are obvious. Okay. Let's head over here.
What? It's you! That's it, Luigi. I'm gonna stomp you into space bits.
Oh, he's mad now. Alrighty, rematch time. And basically, this battle plays almost the same as the first one back in the Fountain Dome did. Only difference is... Well, a few differences. Bowser's gonna do that spin attack you just saw right there. I guess that's like his own version of like the cosmic... spin or whatever, but yes. Alright. So yeah, he's all pissed off. Got him all worked up. He's gonna spit his fireballs. He's gonna spit a lot of fireballs. So yeah. Then he's just gonna keep jumping. Whoa! That's not good. But yeah, he's gonna do that spin attack that you just saw there with the purple things. Come on, Bowsy. Bowsy Wowsy. So awesome. Right. Oh, wow, he smashed the platform. Uh-oh, now he's pissed. Spit them fireballs, er, boy. I'm not sure what that was, like, supposed to be. Yeah, I don't know what that was supposed to be referencing, if anything. So, yes, lots of shockwaves. Yeah, he's doing that purple spin attack there, and it can kind of be annoying, but you can block it, but just be prepared for him to do it again, like that. Actually, it's almost easier just to dodge it. But yes, we should just have to do this one more time. Bowser, where are you? There we go. And wow! And one more time, he's going really fast. There we go. Right on the head. And Luigi has a soft landing.
Wahahaha! Not bad. I guess I chose the right guy to be my arch enemy.
Well, I thought that was Mario.
At least you always put up a fight. But it's too bad for you, because my master plan is almost complete. Tough luck, Luigi.
And Bowser has escaped again. But this is not the end, because we got another grand star. All right. What? You got the star. I love doing that. Anywho, back to the observatory we go. And this grand star is special because not only is it just a grand star, but this is going to give us access to the upper level of the observatory. All right. Yay, the platform starts moving. Yeah, that's the highlight of it all. Ooh. Another new dome has been opened. Okay. 64 stars, galaxy complete. We're good. We have discovered how many new galaxies? All new galaxies in the next new dome. Plus one galaxy out here. What is that galaxy, you may ask? Well, we shall see in a second here. We have ascertained the location of your special one. Please take a look at the circle by your feet. It's a number! That number represents the power stars you need to reach the center of the universe. That number will decrease with each power star you recover. And when it reaches zero, the Comet Observatory will regain full power and fly as a starship again. And then we will be able to reach the center of the universe. So we will not save. The observatory has full power, and now it can fly through the cosmos again. Alright, we've gotten enough stars to go to the center of the universe. That's what that extra galaxy was. It's time. Do you want to go to the location of your special one? Wait. We will wait. And we'll speak to her when we're ready. So yes, this number has appeared on the ground right here. This represents the number of stars we need to get to the center of the universe. And the center of the universe is where Bowser has Peach. That is the final level of the game. We're not gonna do that yet, because... we're just not gonna do that yet, because obviously we haven't completed everything we need to complete. And, I'll explain more in the next episode. So... yes, we've unlocked another new dome. Let's talk to Polari here. We've unlocked the engine room dome, and we will be starting on that dome in the next episode. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever. Thank goodness we're finally done with the bedroom dome, and I will see you guys later.